Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to actual Wednesday with the Colonel. I hope that you all are doing all right. Thank you so much for tuning in. I am Ronaldo Jose, and in the car, for some interesting reason, we've got Chris White. Chris, how are you doing, buddy?
I'm doing fine. I'm here at a mostly peaceful protest in Kenosha, Wisconsin.
at a mostly
never
peaceful.
That's never going to stop being hilarious. The dude's got a car dealership on fire behind him, and kids running down the street shooting people.
Mostly peaceful. Please. No.
Actually, we're live outside Parliament in Cape Town, where rumor has it the Speaker of Parliament has resigned with immediate effect.
Yes, but it's clearly not an admission of guilt. Clearly not an admission of guilt.
Yeah, it's interesting to see the ANC actually go after one of their own. But I mean, look, this when she was defense minister, I repeatedly said what an incompetent twit she was. Of course, you know, that makes you a misogynist and a racist for simply pointing out her incompetence. But hey, you know, that's a risk you take when you tell people the facts.
Yeah, it's always amazing how the ANC seems to find their moral compass when you're on the eve of an election. It's like...
Is there an election in South Africa?
Yeah. And then you've got Fikile Mbalula that posts a photo of himself saying, just arrived in whatever the country... Well, it must be... the Nile goes far down. So he announced on X that he arrived somewhere... And then the video is of him overlooking the Nile in like the most tranquil sunset ever. And I'm like, you are literally letting people put up posters for you in dangerous areas. And you are just like relaxing on a boat in the Nile. It's like insane.
Yeah, speaking of dangerous areas, did you see that hectic story where 9 gangsters were shot in Marion Hill and Kate said, the cops, they knocked on the wrong door. They're lucky they didn't get shot.
Jeez, that's crazy.
That's Saps. Well done, Saps. But yeah. Apparently they returned fire and took out 9 of the 11.
I would just like to know like how many bullets were fired. That's what I would like to know. Because, yeah.
1 billion rounds.
I mean, in order to hit... I mean, how many did they kill? 9 or 8?
Nine.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to know the ballistics information on all of that. Because, I mean, I'm pretty sure it wasn't like 1 bullet per, you know, gangster.
It was no John Wick operation. That's for damn sure.
Yeah, exactly. So,
to be fair, John Wick does use 2 rounds sometimes, though, because he double taps to the head when make sure.
Yeah, and he uses the firearm literally like a sword, like pah, pah, he does that. No.
Oh man, John Wick.
So yeah, I mean, what else is breaking news? Like my brain has literally turned into like mush with the elections. I mean, it's only the third now, so. It's not even like it's less than 2 months, I suppose, which is great. But it's
and mine is less than 3 weeks. Yours is less than 2 months.
Yeah. So I mean, yours is gonna be. It's gonna be. How long before you'll know? Would you like? Is your election so small that within like a couple of hours you'll know?
Technically, I should be able to get the results watching TV if they bother to report the local races by. Probably midnight that night, but that won't count the mail-in ballots. But Republicans, I'm running a Republican primary. Republicans, by and large, don't do mail-in ballots. It's only 10% or less normally. So, you know, depending on how big a lead, it might not affect the outcome. But in a 5-person race, it's a wild card. So I definitely know probably for sure that night, but definitely the next day, you know, the results. So. Anyway, it won't be like Trump where they counted ballots for days after the election.
Yeah, and then all the mail-in ballots suddenly appeared. I've heard rumors of a lot of people registering without actual ID photos. Like, so they're registering without even photo ID.
I think that's fake news or misinformation that's being spread by somebody because I saw Pennsylvania was listed, Texas, Pennsylvania, some other state, and I can tell you that in Pennsylvania, you can't register the vote without identification. You get identification if you go to get a driver's license or photo ID. You can register then, but that's after you've gotten your photo ID at the same location. But you can't register to vote without a photo ID. So I don't know where that's coming from.
It's
Now,
actually coming from
unless,
Elon
yeah, who's
Musk.
it coming from? Well, yeah, but Elon Musk doesn't get everything right, so he might be retweeting something that someone else came up with. Now, that I'm not saying that there aren't people committing crimes. I don't know, but I'm just telling you the process for registering to vote. I know specifically because 4 years ago, I had to transfer because I retired from the Army from voting in Ohio, surrender my driver's license, get issued a Pennsylvania driver's license, and get registered to vote at the same time.
So
And I
let
had
me
to have
read it to
photo ID to
you.
do that.
It says the number of voters registering without a photo ID is skyrocketing in three key swing states,
Right.
Arizona, Texas, and Pennsylvania. Since the start of 2024, Texas 1.2 million people, PA 600,000, and Arizona 220,000. They say HAVV allows voters to register with a social security number, 4 digits. Illegals are not able to get licenses there, but they can get social security cards for work authorization permits. Data is publicly available. And then it goes ssa.gov, HAV, or whatever the
Well, you
thing is
can
called.
present a Social Security card as identification to vote in Pennsylvania rather than a photo ID because there's no photo on that. But I'm not aware that you can register to vote without it. I stand to be corrected, but I mean, I went through the process 4 years ago. So look, I don't put anything past the other side of the political aisle. There's all kinds of shenanigans take place, but I can't confirm that information.
No, that's fine. Bevan says, will asks, will there be special days to vote for people with disabilities? I'm assuming you're talking about my the election in South Africa. Yes, the 27th and 28th. On the 15th of April, you'll be able to go online and register with the IEC to cast a special vote. And then that could either be you going to the voting station on the 27th or 28th, or they can do a home visit. The negative thing with the home visit, of course, is that you have to stay there until they come past your house. So you pretty much you don't know when they will arrive. So yeah, you'll be able to register for a special vote, and if you're able to go to the voting station, there's going to be no queues to answer your
On our
question.
end, in Pennsylvania, because each state is different, in Pennsylvania we have a special machine that can be for people who have like cystic fibrosis. They put a mouthpiece where they can breathe to register their vote.
Oh, wow.
Also, if someone's yeah, we also have one for people, you know, they can't use their hands. It audibly will pick up, you know, will tell them, and they can. There's different. It's for people physically disabled or handicapped to do a multitude of things. I've never had to use it. However, I have had legally blind people come who bring someone with them that's authorized. They can be the person to help them do their ballot. So we handle people who are physically disabled at the polling station. However, if you can't get to a polling station, there's always been a remedy. It's a federal absentee mail-in ballot. But now with the mail-in, no excuse mail-in ballots, they can also request that. So if you're physically unable, you're in a care facility or elderly facility, and you can't leave there, you can still vote. But those are done through the mail, and that's how the mail stuff. But for people who are physically disabled to actually make it to the polling station, we have means for all sorts of ways to do it. It's really fascinating. The machine's pretty impressive.
Yaku says, what will happen if they don't get to you to vote, or is there no sp no they have to complete the lists, so they have to make sure that they've got enough people to do so. And then if for whatever reason they don't get to you, then you can just contact the ward council and they will make sure that that takes place. They have to by law. If you've registered for a home visit and they don't come to your house, then they have breached their agreement and they've breach the Constitution. Although, I mean, it is the IEC, so, but yeah.
You were saying that you weren't up on the current news because you've been so busy. I don't know if you saw, but Trump now leads Biden by a wide margin in 6 of the 7 key battleground states that determine the election.
Yeah, but it
So,
doesn't matter
well,
because the mail-in ballot people are gonna wake up 3 days after the election.
I didn't say Trump is going to win. I just said he's leading in 6 of 7. It's also a long way to November. All
Didn't
kinds of things can
he
happen.
declare his running mate as well?
Did he? I didn't see that. He's been talking about it, but as far as I know, he hadn't picked someone yet.
I think Lauren watched something earlier today, and it says that Trump chooses his running mate. Let me just Google it. When will Trump make his VP's pick? Okay, so it hasn't happened. I think that they were obviously talking about one of was a female lady. Can't remember what her name is.
Kristi Noem, maybe.
Yeah, I think it's her.
She's a governor of North Dakota, or I think it's North Dakota. Yeah.
Yeah.
Rock the scientists solid asked conservative.
If you, sorry, a lot of people are just asking about special votes. If you're not disabled, can you ask for a home visit? No, you actually have to have... Look, unless you're like sick in bed, like literally like very ill, then no, you can not do a home visit unless you've got an actual valid reason for not being able to leave your home. So if you were...
What if I identify as having COVID?
Yeah, unfortunately, no, that's not good enough. So, you have to actually have a reason for not being able to leave your house. And by the way, if the IEC does find that you have abused that privilege, then they can, take steps for especially good. Wasting people resources.
People should be punished for misusing the system. Absolutely, 100%.
Yeah. I mean, I think it's important that as many people register for a special vote to go into the voting station to avoid the queues. But you need a reason. So your reason could be that you're busy on the day. Your reason could be that you can't stand for extended periods in one place. So you don't really need a reason other than just you're busy on the day to go to a voting station on special vote day. And I would highly recommend that as many people do that as possible, especially if you've got weak knees, you know?
So listen, you're in an opposition party, so I have some fodder for you and your fellow opposition parties against the African National Congress. One thing that someone should start talking about is that South Africa under the ANC has become so bad that 4,238 South African nationals currently have got political asylum abroad. Because they were unsafe in South Africa. Their lives were in danger from the government or from the situation. 4,238. According to statistics, South Africa, the largest destination for asylum seekers being who've been granted, the United States, followed by Ireland, and then United Kingdom comes up after that. Australia, I think, is third.
It's so weird. I mean, it's very interesting, but I mean, it's weird that it is getting that. I remember there was one case of a guy that wanted to go to Canada or to the United States that used that. And then South African media, do you guys remember it in the chat? There was this one guy that used that excuse. I think it was before like all of these wars that are taking place now. But I mean, he said that he felt...
Brendan Huntley back in 2004 tried to get asylum in Canada, claiming he'd been stabbed 7 times. Yeah, they turned him down.
And I mean, and the media made like such a shit storm out of it, saying, oh, this guy is just an opportunist. He's trying. And I mean, that is when our murder rate was like already like, what, 40 murders a day, 50 murders a day?
Now it's 85.
So, yeah. And
well,
I mean,
the DA's just won some court case with costs. I didn't see what it was. Just came across on Twitter. It zipped through real fast.
So they won, the ANC has not given all the documents with regards to CADA deployment, so they've won the case to say that the ANC is in contempt of court, which now means they've got 15 days to hand over all documents, including documents that they proclaim that they don't have, which is the hard drive that apparently got... deleted or formatted.
All the records of the meetings on it.
All the WhatsApps, all the messages with Cyril Ramaphosa. And if they can't produce it, then they're once again in contempt of court, which means then that Fikile Mbalula will go to jail. That's what it means.
Yay! Can't wait for that. Clock is ticking. Looking forward to that.
And we all know that, you know, being in contempt of court, because remember, I believe this is also, it's a constitutional court decision. Which means that there is no higher court to take it up with, which means that if in 15 days they don't provide all the information, including Cyril Ramaphosa's lost correspondence when he was the chairperson, then the courts can literally sentence Fikile Mbalula because he's a respondent on behalf of the ANC. Right. And we all know how this turned out for Jacob Zuma when he was in contempt of court.
Right. But here's the other piece of this too. If you're sentenced to a crime like that for more than 12 months within a 5-year period, you're ineligible to serve in office. So this could be the disappearance of Fikile Mbalula because obviously it will, if he gets convicted of contempt and he gets 13 months, he's not
after
going,
the after the You know, maybe that is why he is like on the Nile. It's just because he's in denial.
Maybe he's seeking asylum.
Maybe. But here's the thing. Like, he's been doing such a terrible job at being the what is his position? Secretary General for the ANC. Yeah. He's been doing such a shit job that I wouldn't blame the ANC if they just go, sorry, Fikile, you need to take one for the team, bud. We'll release 15,000 prisoners in 6 months from now, and you will suddenly get this like illness that you can't recover from, but that you can get.
Shakelitis.
Yeah, Shakelitis. Shabir Shakelitis. But yeah, I mean, it's going to be interesting because, you know, fuck around and find out. That's what's going to happen.
Well, it's interesting because it looks like the ANC is cutting ties and cutting the apron strings. No se sigue Mapisa Naula now is gone from parliament and may soon be having a knock on the door from SAPS to arrest her.
Yeah, she lost her court case against that as well. I mean, how arrogant are you not to think that you are above you're above the law to get arrested? Like, she was fighting that she should not be arrested. And I'm like, how is this even a case? How can you fight to be arrested? You can be arrested. It doesn't mean you're guilty. It just means that there is enough suspicion that you've committed a crime. That is what it means.
Yep. Or enough evidence that makes it likely that they could get a criminal conviction. Yeah, no, it's very cheeky of her. Yeah, go ahead. No, it's very cheeky of her. It just shows you how arrogant the ANC is and disconnected from reality.
Yeah, and I mean, of course, in true South African fashion, it's something like, what was it, a couple of million rand and a wig. It's like, it always has to be the weirdest thing. You know, it can never just be 2 million rand and that's it. You know, it's always like 1 million rand and a bucket of KFC, or 1 million rand and a wig, or 1 million rand and a Gucci handbag. It's always that one odd gift that you just don't expect, but it's there.
You're right about that. Yeah, well, listen, voters got to go to the polls. I'm so sick of hearing people whine about opposition parties. Do something about it. Go vote the ruling party out and give the opposition parties a chance to try to rule South Africa. But again, folks, if somehow the multi-party charter and or some amalgamation of opposition parties are able to get 50+1 or rule as a minority government with 40-some% being the largest bloc, if that somehow happens, South Africa will not magically transform tomorrow or next year. The damage done by the ANC is so grievous that it will take time to repair it. The infrastructure that's been destroyed, the money that's been looted, the things that haven't been done will take years to address. And on top of that, do not forget that the bureaucracy has been put in place by the ANC, full of their acolytes, their cater hires, and they're also their friends and family approach to patronage, and many incompetent people, and also some people that would intentionally go slow and sabotage opposition efforts to improve governance in South Africa. So you must know this in advance, folks, but that's not an excuse to sit on your bum, to sit on your ass, not go vote, and change South Africa's trajectory. Because if you don't, your country's in the shitter, and it's never coming back.
Exactly. And while you were saying that, on the screen right now, I've got the actual national ballot that has got, let's count it quick, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 24, 26, 28, 30, 32, 34, 36, 38, 40, 42, 44, 46, 48, 50, 52, I think 52 or 53 parties. 52 or 53 parties, right? Now, if you honestly want to tell me in Democratic South Africa that you can't get a party that represents your interests out of 52 or 53 parties, then you are the problem. It's It can't. You can try and bullshit as many people as you want, but at the end of the day, there's 52 parties out of there that surely you can get somebody that represents your interests. Surely.
Fair point. I can't disagree with that. My point is that people need to get out and vote.
Yeah, and the annoying thing at the moment, unfortunately, is that everybody in the opposition is attacking the opposition. This is the weakest that the ANC has been in our history as a democracy. And yet, for some unknown reason, people like Musi Maimane, that has to call a party after his, like, build One South Africa with Musi Maimane. That is his party's name. His party's name is not Build One South Africa. No. His party's name is Build One South Africa with Musi Maimane. So, and then here's like a shining example, right? So the ANC has got so many failures. The EFF is campaigning on hatred, right? So what does Musi Maimane do? He goes on X and he says, "I'm challenging John Steenhuisen to a debate. Let's see if he really is what." And I'm like, you know, you don't even want to join the multi-party charter. Like, this is for you. This is something to stroke your ego, right? We need to all...
It's a vanity project.
Yeah. I mean, it's in the name. It's in the name.
It's literally in the name.
It's literally in the name.
It's not the Patriotic Alliance with Gate McKenzie. It's just the Patriotic Alliance.
Yeah. No, now it went from BOSA to BOSAMM. BOSAMM.
That sounds like a sexually transmitted infection.
Affection. Affection, not infection. Yeah, it's crazy. Like, I mean, and the thing is, you can say what you want about the DA, but show me a political party that has spoken more about the multi-party charter. You won't find it. Simple as that.
UIM. Neil De Beers talked a lot about it.
Yeah, but not as much as the DA. So what I'm saying is a lot of people have been saying, oh, you know, the DA needs to focus on this. And that's exactly, you know, it's like, once again, it's you're damned if you do and you're damned if you don't. So you need to sit there and allow people to just hurl shit at you all the time and insults. And you can't say anything, because if you turn to the ANC and you say, hey, shut up, because look at your track record, then it's like, oh, the DA can't campaign on its own. It always has to talk about the ANC. And then when they say, When the opposition parties attack you and you turn and you say, guys, can we focus on one? And then it's like, oh, you know, the DA can't work with other parties. They always have to fight with other parties. It's like, what the hell? For some unknown reason in South Africa, people have this thing that you have to agree with the political party you vote for 100%. Because if you don't, then it's not a party that you should vote for. And it's like, that's absurd. If you agree with a political party 100%, then you're not in a political party. You're in a cult. That's what you are.
Because
there's no way. I don't agree with the DA 100%. I believe the DA is quite soft on something like the death penalty. You know, my belief is that we believe in the Constitution, and that is fine. However, our stance on the death penalty is on constitutionalism. So if the death penalty was in the Constitution, we would then be for the death penalty. But because it's not in the Constitution, it means we're not for the death penalty, which is like that. So even myself as a candidate, I love the DA, and I think that over the overarching theme of the DA and the overwhelming majority of the DA is on the right course and the right track, and it is the most viable option and the best option for South Africa. But I don't even agree with everything within the DA. You can't. It's impossible. You can never ever agree with 100%. I mean, do you agree 100% with your wife, to the people listening? Do you agree with 100% with your best friend, with your brother, with your sister, like with your favorite TV show, with your favorite coffee? You know, no.
But it's fascinating because South Africans are willing to put up with the pervasive failures, corruption, incompetence of the ANC, and then with one issue attack an opposition party. Yeah, but what about this part? What about this? you know, nobody's without sin. Nobody is mistake or error free. Everybody makes mistakes, but there is no question that South Africans are demonstrably poorer and in worse condition today, and it's almost all South Africans, than they were in 1994. The only difference is that people aren't discriminated against based on the skin color. Well, wait a second. There's 160 laws that do that in South Africa. Yeah. So people are demonstrably worse than they were in 94. And only one party has ruled the country since 1994. So there's no elephant in the room. It's just a hippo. And he looks like Ramaphosa.
Yeah. And, of course, the height of irony is the fact that it's still apartheid's fault. It's like it's been 30 years. And then, the height of irony is actually the fact that the ANC celebrates on social media the fact that the premier of Gauteng for the ANC has managed to get rid of e-tolls. I mean, you know, things like that. So
they put in place.
Yeah. So who gave us e-tolls? And why are you celebrating the fact that you implemented something that failed miserably and should never have been there in the first place?
Yeah, no doubt about it.
No, South Africa is a special country. South Africa truly is a special country.
Trying to reach out to Snot Cop to get him to do a song about Pala Pala.
Well, you can do that now, by the way. I mean, I'm not sure if you've seen the stream that I did where there's a website called Suno.ai, and you literally say what you wanted to say or what you wanted to sing about and in what type of genre and in what language, and then it creates a 2-minute song for you with real instruments and real vocals, it's mind-blowing.
Cool. I don't need Snot Cop. I can make my own kind of song and cut it.
I want like a husky male voice in a pop or rock genre or country genre to write.
I want rap.
Yeah, okay, well, a hip-hop song then. But here's the thing. You can even write a jingle for yourself for your campaign. You can say, I am Chris Wyatt. I'm a military veteran with this many years experience. Write a 30-second jingle for me telling people to vote for me in the upcoming whatever. And then
you got to send me this link.
Man, let me actually, I'm going to do it and play it live for you. That's what I'm going to do right now.
Okay.
So, let's do it live. Because then, I mean, you'll be able to obviously listen.
I don't need Snot Cop.
Okay, well, you can't do Snot Cop, but you can.
No, I don't need him now. I was going to get him to do a song.
Oh, okay. let me create a, so I'm going to say, create a jingle in a hip-hop format. In the hip hop genre about voting for Chris Wyatt in the upcoming, what is it called?
92nd district
Republican. How do you spell Pennsylvania? Fuck, it's so weird.
T-E-N-N.
Yeah.
S-Y-L.
Okay, wait. You, the speaker. P-E-N-N.
S-Y-L.
S-Y-L.
V-A-N-I-A. Pennsylvania.
Okay. Upcoming 92nd District, Pennsylvania, Republican primary. Or what was it? Republican. No, it's not primary.
Primary.
Okay, so I'm not even going to talk about your military. I'm just going to...
Yeah, let's see what it says. Let's see what it does.
So I said create a jingle in the hip-hop genre about voting for Chris Wyatt in the upcoming 92nd District, Pennsylvania Republican primary. That's all I said. It's going to give two versions of this.
All right, let's see.
So, okay, it's going to take about another 10, 15 seconds to do that. the name of the song is called Vote for Wyatt.
There you go.
I just hope it gets your surname right.
I hope I can hear it.
Well, I'm sure you will. But I'll send you the link. But it's phenomenal. So I wrote a jingle for Tapas. I wrote... Like the other day, Carter and Kennedy, we did an Easter egg hunt for them here in the house. So then just to create something to send to my parents, I created like a two-minute song where they mentioned Carter and Kennedy doing an egg hunt. Okay, let me download it here. Oh wait, can you hear this? Wait, can you hear this?
Yeah, listen up, y'all. It's time to make a choice. In the 92nd district, let's raise our voice. Chris White is the name, he's the one.
Okay. Let me just download it then. Okay, it's still creating it. I wonder why it doesn't want to.
To elect that Republican primary, you better expect from Pennsylvania.
Well, I think it might be playing it for the people, but we can't hear it because of Zoom's capturing laws and stuff. Okay, so just give me a second. I'm waiting for it to promulgate so that you can download it, because it's still busy with that. Could people, let me just ask the guys in the live stream, could you, oh, okay, they could hear it. I have to, I think, play it with VLC so that we can hear it here. What I might do is I might actually just WhatsApp it to you quick, and then, are you on your phone?
Yeah, I'm on my phone, so I'll have to listen to it after I go off, but yeah.
No, I want to play it on here.
You want my reaction.
Let me just check if I can fix this. I think if I just enable it, okay, wait. Can I download yet? Yeah, here we go. Download audio. Okay, and then do the second one, download audio. Okay, let's see if I open it like this, if it'll work. Oh, wow. Okay, this is actually good. I need to put it on the speaker.
Because I can hear it.
Okay, let me just fix this. Oh, give me a second. Okay, I'm going to put this loud, so you're probably going to hear. Oh, wait. How do I do this where you can... Because everybody... Okay, you can't hear it. Let's see if it works. Okay, let me do this. This should make it work. Taking out my... Okay.
Pretty good. The only problem is I wasn't born and raised here, so that I have to do another one where it takes that part out. But yeah, send me the link and send me that. I'm gonna have fun with that.
So that was the first,
because I got it. Yeah,
that was the first one that it creates two for you. So
okay, let's hear
and one. You couldn't even hear it. That's all. I mean, it's actually really really good. Here's the second one. I mean, you get the idea. Now, please.
I do, and I've got an idea what I'm going to do. I'm going to do probably a pop and probably do a pop version and do a rap version. But I got to put a few things in there so it doesn't put that born and raised, because I wasn't born and raised. I've been born and raised in America, so I do that. But anyway, that's pretty cool. Well, I got to drop off, unfortunately. It's time. Anyway, thanks a lot. It's great chatting with you again. Next week, I'm also here. I'll have to check the schedule. I think we'll be able to do with broadcast. If not, I'll let you know. And thanks to everybody who's been tuning in. I'll let you wrap up the show and do the last bit here. We got elections coming up. April 23rd this side, May 29th that side. Folks, make sure you're registered and go
vote.
Don't
you want to swap? Can't we swap, please? Like, I wish we were only 20 days away. Like, really.
It's actually going to be a relief that this one's out of the way. If I win, then I got 6 months till November. So,
yeah. Well, anyway, thanks for joining. Good luck. Keep going hard. It's almost there. So good luck, bud. And we'll chat soon. But I'll send you the link after this night. Cool.
Thanks, cheers, man. Cheers. Bye-bye.
Bye. All right, everybody, from my side, I'm not going to stay on that much longer because I also need to spend some time with my wife. She hasn't seen me in quite a long time, actually, because I've been so busy. But yeah, how cool is this? By the way, if you don't know the app that I was talking about, I'll put it here in the chat. It's Suno.ai. You can literally write a song about anything. Literally. You can tell it what to sing about, in what genre. You can even do Afrikaans music. And it is absolutely insane. So Suno.ai, go and mess around with it. I believe, when was it? Was it Sunday? Yes, I told people about it, and then they wrote songs for their children, etc., etc., etc. So yeah, thank you all for tuning in. It's greatly appreciated. I hope that you had a great week so far. Look after yourselves. I will catch you. When will I catch you again? I might. I'll catch you on Sunday, but I might catch you sooner. I might do a stream either Friday evening or Saturday, but I'll keep you updated with that. And thank you all for tuning in. Have a lovely rest of your week. And yeah, that's pretty much all I got to say. Till later. Cheers and peace out.